reading to you from the 10th chapter of John, the Gospel of John, 27th verse. My sheep hear my voice, and I know them, and they follow me. And I give unto them eternal life, and they shall never perish, neither shall any man pluck them out of my hand. My Father, which gave them me, is greater than all, and no man is able to pluck them out of my Father's hand. Good evening, my dear listening friends. Again, this is Evangelist Cecil Moe. And you know, I'm a converted alcoholic, gave my heart to Christ over 49 years ago in the pastor's home in Seattle, Washington. 1 year later, God called me to preach, and I've been sharing Christ ever since. Listen, be sure tomorrow to be praying for the quartet and my wife and I as we go to Jefferson County Prison. When you pray, God gives us souls for our hire. Oh, listen, friends, it's such a joy. I may be almost 80 years old, but it gets better every day. Listen to me. If you're old, don't you quit sharing Jesus. Hey, some of us old folks can still share it. Oh, I spoke at a memorial the other day, and I told those people about this lady. It was a prayer warrior on my other station. God took her home, but oh, the hours we spent in prayer together, and what a joy. Well, I'll be with you for 28 minutes. Kick off your slippers, sit back and relax. Pour you a glass of iced tea or a cup of coffee. Let's see what the Lord has for us, okay? If you have your Bibles with you, turn with me to the 9th chapter of the book of Acts, and let's begin reading with the first verse. And Saul, yet breathing out threatenings and slaughter against the disciples of the Lord, went unto the high priest, and desired of him letters to Damascus to the synagogues, that he found any of this way, whether they were men or women, he might bring them bound in Jerusalem. And as he journeyed, he came near Damascus, and suddenly there shined around about him a light from heaven. And he fell to the earth, and heard a voice saying unto him, Saul, Saul, why persecutest thou me? And he said, Who art thou, Lord? And the Lord said, I am Jesus, whom thou persecutest. It is hard for thee to kick against the pricks. And he, trembling and astonished, said, Lord, what will thou have me to do? And the Lord said unto him, Arise, and go unto the city, and it shall be told thee what thou must do. And the men which journeyed with him stood speechless, hearing the voice, but seeing no man. And Saul arose from the earth, and when his eyes were opened, he saw no men, but they led him away by the hand, and brought him unto Damascus. And there he was 3 days without sight, and neither did he eat nor drink. Friends, I'd like to talk about the witnessing of Paul, who we're talking about was Saul, but later his name was changed to Paul. Friends, listen. Paul, or I should say Saul, truly hated witnessing Christians. Oh, he did. He was doing everything he could to stomp out Christianity. He thought he was doing God's will. Later on, he admitted that he did it in total ignorance. He had approved the stoning of Stephen, the first Christian martyr. And I'll tell you, my dear friends, that must have been an experience. Oh, listen, Stephen told them exactly where they were headed. He told them exactly what they did to Jesus. They couldn't bear it. And so they started throwing stones at him. They put their hands over their ears. They screamed, and they screamed. And finally, they stoned Stephen to death, and he gave up the ghost. And what he said before he went out in eternity, Father, forgive them, lead us not to their charge. How many, many Christians could do that? Boy, I don't hope I'd ever had to be put to that test. But anyway, you see, there's a lot of people in the churches today who say they're Christians and believe they're Christians, only they're not Christians. Why aren't they Christians? Because they have not been born again, like Jesus told Nicodemus, the religious ruler, who was not a drunk, he was not a whoremonger, he was religious, but his religion wasn't enough to take him into heaven. And maybe that's your trouble tonight. Maybe you go to church, maybe you study the Bible, you may even teach a Sunday school class, but deep down in your heart, you knew if you'd die tonight, you'd miss heaven. Why? Because you hadn't put your trust in Jesus. See, meeting Jesus on the road to Damascus changed Paul's life forever. You know, I'm always being kidded by my dear friends about, well, old Cecil will take a text and he'll shoot right off to his testimony. Beloved, listen, I learned that from Paul. That man was not afraid to tell what he had Jesus. Listen, every born-again believer has a testimony. Some's more interesting than others. You know that, and I know that. But you know what you should do? If you have a testimony that doesn't really bring much fruit, you need to ask the Lord how to give your testimony. That's right. And I don't mean make a fake testimony. You tell exactly where the Lord got a hold of your heart, and tell the day that you got on your knees. Because you see, friends, it's a definite experience. That's right, it's a one-shot experience. And if you're lost tonight, it's not Jesus' fault, because the Bible said he came to seek and to save that which is lost. Meeting Jesus on the road to Damascus changed Paul, I mean forever. He said, Lord, what will thou have me to do? Boy, oh boy. I mean, and he said, Lord, what do you want me to do? Oh, friends, the Lord said, arise and go. Started Paul going, and he kept witnessing for life, all the rest of his life. And he trembled and astonished, said, Lord, what will they have me do? Well, God wanted to be a witness. God wanted to be a preacher. God wanted to be a soul winner. And he did all of those jobs, and he did them well. Almost half the New Testament was written by Paul. See, Paul would be a chosen witness. In verse 15 it says, But the Lord said unto him, go thy way, for he is a chosen vessel unto me to hear my name before the Gentiles and kings and children of Israel. Friends, listen, when I speak in these big fancy churches or preach revivals around the world, around the country, wherever I've gone, I don't feel any different than when I go to Skid Row and preach in the rescue missions, or I preach in prison. Why? Because I know how they feel. And I know that God changed my life completely, and he can choose and change their life the same way. Paul had been stricken blind during his encounter with Christ. Ananias was to pray for him and restore his sight. But you know what? Ananias was reluctant. He sure was. Verse 13, then Ananias answered, Lord, I have heard by many about this man, how much evil he hath done to thy saints at Jerusalem. And here he hath authority from the chief priest to bind all that call on thy name. He said, man, this guy is evil. He is too much. The Lord said, you put your hands on him, and I'll tell you what he's going to do. Oh, but listen, he would have beaten and imprisoned anybody that he can get his hands on. Like Stephen, he would be stoned for his witnessing. I wonder if you and I have such a witness for the Lord that people, we might be stoned for our witness. Friends, listen, don't you think that many of our dear black brothers over in Africa are being killed by the quote-unquote religious Muslims? They're killing them. They're torturing them. They're raping the women. Oh, I don't know what's going to happen. But you think God's got his eyes shut? Oh, no. Don't you remember the children of Israel down in Egypt, and they were being beaten and poorly treated? And so one night, all these people were praying, oh, God, send someone to deliver us out of the hands of these horrible, wicked people. Guess who he called? An old sheep herder. Come on, Moses, you old sheep herder. Out there, he'd already killed a couple of guys, I guess, and he was out there herding sheep and thinking his life was all over. But wait a minute, wait a minute, wait a minute, Moses. God's got a little job for you to do. Yes, he does. And he said, you're standing on holy ground. And he called Moses to do a job that was incredibly hard, just like he called Noah to do an incredibly hard job. And he said, all right, Lord. But he said, you know, I just can't speak. I just cannot speak. The Lord said, well, I'll give him your brother. Well, it didn't happen that way, did it? When Moses got down there and saw his people again, all of a sudden he began to realize they were his people. And he was called of God. Friends, you and I who know Jesus are called of God today. You may not be called to be a preacher. You may not be called to be a Sunday school teacher. But I'll guarantee you, according to my Bible, in the book of Acts, you are called. You are given the, you're empowered to be a witness and a soul winner for Jesus. Oh, listen. Paul's witnessing would be clearly defined. He would continually major on the cross. That's a secret, beloved. Talk about Jesus. You know, I got fired off the radio station that I preached on this town for 30 long years. 30 long years. One day said, you're through. They took my program, who I gave invitations every Sunday night for 30 years, and they replaced my broadcast with rock and roll music that you shouldn't use in a pig pen. And I got a call, several calls, from my listeners, old listeners, said, Cecil, you know what? Where are you at? I've called that station, and they won't tell me where you're broadcasting, or if you are broadcasting. Well, I said, they call themselves a Christian organization, but it's obvious they don't practice what they preach. Now, friends, I'm afraid there's too many people who call themselves Christians who are on the road to a devil's hell. They're liars. They're deceivers. Now, it's not God's fault. You know, he would witness about the resurrection and the power of Christ to save. Paul would witness the Gentiles and government leaders. He didn't care if they were rich or they were poor. He did not care. All he knew that God had saved him on the road to Damascus and called him to do a job, and he was doing it well. He would bear the name of Christ to the Gentiles. Paul would be the greatest missionary of all time. I believe that too. Neither persecution, privation, or pain could stop him. Oh, people tried to kill him. They wanted to silence his tongue. Sure they did. You know, Christians, like I say, I got fired on a station for preaching Jesus. And, you know, the thing is, I feel sorry for some of those people call me and say, Cecil, you know, I loved your broadcast. I have never, beloved, ever claimed to be a great, smart preacher. You've never heard me say that. I'm trying to be a humble servant of the Most High, because he reached down in a gutter and saved me, an old alcoholic, and put a love in my heart for alcoholics and drug addicts, prisoners, those who are down and out. God put that love in there. I didn't conjure it up. He put it to me. Paul's witnessing journey would bring many to Jesus. You know, a prophecy was given to Ananias about Paul witnessing before rulers. Remember when he witnessed to Felix and Festus? And remember when he witnessed to King Agrippa? Listen, almost thou persuadest me to be a Christian. Oh, I hope tonight, if you're listening to this broadcast and you don't know Christ, that you won't be almost persuaded. You'll let the Holy Spirit of God persuade you. You let the Holy Spirit of God draw your heart, draw your eye to him. Fall on your knees and say, oh God, I realize that I'm a sinner. And I know I can't save myself, and I know I don't deserve to go to heaven, but I'm opening my heart tonight. Jesus said, he that cometh unto me, what? I will no wise cast out. No, he won't. You see, Paul was a bad person. Now he's going to heaven. And then there's good persons go to hell. That seemed like a paradox, doesn't it? Give Paul the floor anytime and he will witness about his conversion. And that's what old Cecil Moe does. Not that I'm so smart or so hot, but oh, friends, I remember that morning. 49 years ago, on my knees, I was weeping. I was crying. I told the Lord I was so sorry for what I'd done. Told him that I'd like to have him come into my heart and be my Savior. And friends, listen, he gave me that new life. I've still got the passion and power and tears to talk to men and women about Jesus. You say, Cecil, you know, once in a while you say something about same-sex marriages and homosexual and lesbian. Listen, they're not my enemy. Do I agree with their lifestyle? Of course I don't. Why don't I? Because it don't line up with the book, with God's holy, unerring word. If it did, I could say, go to it. But it's wrong. Beloved, they will not go to heaven. That's what the Bible said. If they're homosexual lesbians, they will not go to heaven until they have been converted to Christ. And when you see one of those men or women get saved, I'll guarantee you they'll get out and witness. You take the Jews, you get a Jew converted to Christ, and boy howdy, he's on fire. Jews for Jesus. Well, Paul would witness to the Jews. Ananias was told that Paul would witness to the children of Israel. And Paul witnessed often in synagogues. His method, he reasoned with them out of the Scriptures. Yes, sir. And he desired of him letters to Damascus to the synagogues that if he found any on his way where they were men or women, he might bring them bound into Jerusalem. But boy, listen, when he got converted, he just did a backward flip. Listen, his message, Christ suffered, died, and rose again. His visit invitation was Christ is the only Savior for the Jew and the Gentile. You know, my quartet, they were raised in Christian homes. They were brought up in the church as little children. But did you know they were just as lost as this their speaker, Cecil Moe, when I was an alcoholic? Everybody has to come through Jesus. Don't try to circumvent Jesus to get to the Father, because if you do, you're going to miss heaven and you're going to go to a burning hell. Paul had a heartfelt burden for the salvation of his people. Listen, consider the alls of Paul's call. He saw all people as sinners and Christ their only hope. And that's where I see it in prison and the men, women, and Skid Row. I see Christ as their only hope. He became all things to all men, that by all means he might save some. Listen, let me ask you a question. Tonight, you say, Cecil, I'm a born-again believer, and I was saved as a young man or a young woman, but you know, I haven't really been satisfied. Well, that don't mean that you don't trust Jesus, but it means that you haven't been using all the power that he is endued you with. Now, if you tonight are not witnessing for Christ or not doing personal evangelism, I tell you what I want you to do. I want you to bow your head to me right now and let's have a word of prayer. Dear Lord, I realize that I haven't been everything I should be. And Father, tonight I'm surrendering my life afresh and anew. I'm confessing my sins and turning my back on the old way of life. I know, Lord, that when you save for once and for all. And no man shall pluck thee out of my hand. Now, dear friend, if you're an unsaved man or woman or a child, won't you consider Jesus tonight? Are you tired of your wayward life? Maybe you're a drug addict. Maybe you're an alcoholic. Maybe you're in sex and you're shacking up. God's not pleased with you, dear ones. Oh, he's not. He loves you, but he doesn't love your sin. Won't you come to Jesus tonight and pray this simple prayer? O God, be merciful to me, a sinner. Lord Jesus, come into my heart and save me tonight for Jesus' sake. Amen. Beloved, if you did that, call 303-471-8534. That's 303-471-8534. I'll not use your name on the air. I'll not sit down and write and ask you for any money. I don't care where you go to church, but oh, dear friends, I care where you spend eternity. Give me a call if you feel a need for Jesus. 303-471-8534. I'm standing by, waiting for your call.
Assurance, Jesus is mine. Oh, what a foretaste of glory divine. Heir of salvation, purchase of God, born of his Spirit, washed in his blood. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. Perfect submission, perfect delight, visions of rapture now burst on my sight. Angels descending, ring from above, echoes of mercy, whispers of love.
Perfect submission, all is at rest. I in my Savior am happy and blessed. Watching and waiting, looking above, filled with his goodness, lost in his love.
This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior.
Friends, I need to give you my mailing address. It's Moe Evangelistic Association, Inc., and it's 9621 South Burberry Lane. That's B-U-R-B-E-R-R-Y. Burberry Lane, Highlands Ranch, Colorado, 80129. You know, I would love to know, I'd love to hear from some of our listeners up in Nebraska, and Wyoming and other places. I'd love to hear from it. Listen, friends, we are not subsidized by any church or any denomination. We do this on people who sit down and write a little check every month to support this ministry before we go to prison. We're not beggars. We're not do that. But if you would like to help us, and I guarantee you, we're seeing souls saved at every service, and that's no jive. If you think I'm kidding you, talk to the quartet. They'll tell you. They've been with me almost 18 years, and they've seen God perform miracles of salvation. And see, friends, I think salvation's the greatest miracle there is in the world. You say, well, I speak in tongues. Well, that's all right. No one's knocking you. You say, well, I'm a healer. I'm not knocking you. I'm just telling you, if you want to see a miracle, give your heart to Jesus and he'll do it. Anyway, if you'd like to help us, sit down, write a check or money order and send it to 9621 South Burberry Lane, Highlands Ranch, Colorado, 80129. Father in heaven, I do thank you so much for the Apostle Paul and for what he did. Oh God, he took his call very serious. And Lord, I've taken my call very serious, but I'm sure not comparing myself to the Apostle Paul. But my main message, Lord, is to tell them how to find Jesus. And that's the joy of my heart and my life. Father, I do pray for those dear, precious people, the faithful little people that sit down and write a check out once a month to our ministry so we can go to prison. I pray, Lord, your richest blessing upon their lives. Because, Lord, if they didn't believe what we were doing was right, I sure doubt if any of them would send anything our way. And then, Lord, I pray for our president tonight and all of his staff members. I pray that, Lord, you raise up allies around the world to stand with our great country. And, Father, I do pray for our servicemen and women overseas. God bless them. God love them. God protect them. And then, dear Lord, I do pray about this election, that people will look at the issues on both sides for both men and decide what you want them to vote. And, oh, God, I don't see how they can go wrong. And, Lord, I'd never tell another person how to vote. I don't think that's my call. My call is to encourage them to vote for the man they think should be the President of the United States. Father, again, thank you so much for this broadcast. And I just happy, Lord, that we can be honored. And even though, Lord, sometimes we get tired and our old bones ache. Ah, but, Lord, someday they ain't going to have those aches and pains. We're going to be with our wonderful Savior. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Well, friends, for the past 58 minutes, your hosts have been Evangelist Cecil Moe. Thank you, dear ones, for listening. Oh, I pray I said something that will help you. If you'd like for me to pray for you, just write me a letter and tell me to pray for you. You don't have to put money in a thing. I pray for people free. Yes, I do. There's no strings attached to my prayers because I know prayer is very important. Well, be sure and vote for my vote. Pray for my wife, and that God will help her make some good real estate sales. Friends, that's actually how her and I eat. We really do. That's our bread and butter. We have no salary. We take no salary from anybody. Well, friends, until this time next Saturday night, be good to your neighbors. Stay sweet. Keep looking up for this wonderful Jesus is coming soon. Good night, and may God bless you real, real good.